sun beating down, no rain, and lots of people here to drink. A few announcements to start with. There are bottles of water at the end of rows here if you need it. The restrooms are in the building behind us. And would you please turn off the cell phones or any of the electronic devices that you have so that we can all listen to what's being said. We've come together to remember 100 years of our American history. During this last century, our country's leadership has asked its bravest young men and women to defend the rights of the oppressed on foreign soil. Even though the location of our military involvement has changed, the sacrifices of our soldiers and their families stay the same. And it is for them we are here today, to honor our veterans, to show our gratitude to those serving today, and to mourn those who never came home.
Let us bow our heads in prayer.
I'm not sure what you said.
Let us pray. Oh God, we gather today to remember and thank you for those of our number who gave their lives in service to our nation and for the causes of freedom, justice, and peace. They and all veterans of war either paid or were willing to pay the ultimate price so that we might be free. Free to speak, free to vote, free to assemble, free to petition our government, and free to worship God. They paid the price, which we cannot calculate in dollars, but only in tears and in memories and in longing. We thank you today for those who paid the ultimate price on the battlefield for us. At this very moment, a soldier might be paying that price for us, a family learning of a deep loss, and a nation mourning another fallen soldier. Make us ever grateful and mindful of the price that has been paid for liberty. Bless the families of those who can only see their loved one in memories this day. Let us all remember them, not just on this day, but every day, for whatever our life is in this great nation, we only have it because of them. Remember that all the freedoms we all enjoy were paid for by a terrible price. We, like all the good people of this world, await the day when war will be no more, when no one will have to die in war so that freedom and justice and peace might be endured. But until that day, we thank you for the fallen and those willing to fall that have allowed us to be the great nation that we are, and that peace and justice and freedom thrives not just here, but in many parts of your great creation. We pray all of these things, and for all that goes on this day, and for your blessings upon us. In God's holy name we pray. Amen.
Carried into battle in faraway lands, always for the cause of freedom. I am bloodstained, torn, and many times weary, and saddened by the thousands who prayed, paid the supreme sacrifice. Do not let it all be for nothing. Tell me the brave has died for a worthwhile cause. Be proud wisdom, of your freedom as I did for your ancestors, and I shall for your heirs. I am your flag.
Thank you.
It is for some of us to maintain our composure as we stand here podium. I always said I could hold it together if I didn't look at Calvin Cook in the audience. Sadly, Calvin's not here with us anymore. I thought it was because I knew both him and his family. Please be seated.
Christopher Swanson, who lost his life on July 22nd, 2006 in Ramadi. He was a resident of Rosehaven here in South County. And so that bridge now is dedicated to his memory. And the most interesting part of that bridge ceremony to me was reminding me of the importance of passing on what we as adults know to the next generation. And that the legislation that allowed that bridge to be dedicated was done so by a delegate from the western side of the state of Maryland. He did it because when he drove into, I believe the state was Virginia or West Virginia, I can't remember which one, he was driving with his son in the car, his 10-year-old son, and as they passed over a bridge, they noticed that it was dedicated to a fallen soldier. So each time they passed over one of these bridges on his long journey, he stopped and they looked up the soldier's bio and read about it. So he used that opportunity of that sign on the side of the road to educate his son. I'm happy to see young people here today. I'm happy to see small families with small children like the Chabones back over here. It's so important to bring out our small children and have them understand the importance of Memorial Day and the ultimate sacrifice that so many people have paid so that we can live in a free country. Thank you.
Like to say, it's a tremendous honor for me to stand here with you today to honor the great men and women who sacrificed so much for their country, their community, their family, and their friends. Unfortunately, as we know, many Americans can be forgetful of the sacrifices made by the brave men and women of our armed forces. However, for veterans and their families, Memorial Day stirs memories of the past, of the loved and the lost. As a veteran myself, it warms my heart to see so many of you here today taking the time to pay respect to those who have given their lives for this great nation. Beyond the many citations for valor are the untold, undocumented stories of men and women who live with the scars of war. So let us also not forget our sons and daughters that have returned home with amputations, disfigurements, physical illnesses, some of my friends, among many other ailments. It is impossible for these veterans and their families to forget the sacrifices they have made, so should it be for all of us too. We all live in a very uncertain world, and no matter how safe we may feel, our freedom is a highly valued and targeted commodity. May we never forget, and especially may we never let our children forget, how unfortunate we are, or how fortunate we are to have a voluntary force of men and women willing to safeguard our freedom so we can rest sound at night. May the memories of our fallen be cherished, their lives celebrated and appreciated, and their sacrifices honored by not only their friends and family, but especially by the country they protected. Long live America. God bless America, God bless Maryland, and God bless South Carolina.
We don't know, nor do we want to know, who you supported in the 2016 campaign or who you voted for. But we sincerely hope you share with us the conviction that we show our thanks and support to our members as often and in as many ways as we can. Because of them, we can vote as we wish, we can speak as we wish, and we can live our lives in freedom without the fear found in so many other countries in the world. If you are an active duty veteran, would you please join in with everyone else who will serve while we play the Armed Forces Net? United States Army. thank you all for your service. Before retiring in 2014, he served with units of the 101st Airborne Air Assault Division, the 82nd Airborne Division, and the 1st Infantry Division. He retired as a Command Sergeant Major from the Joint Improvised Threat Defeat Organization. Please join me in welcoming Bill Todd.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson, for that kind introduction. And let me just say it is an honor to be able to speak to everyone today, especially the fondness of our World War veterans who continue to join us. Well, today, you know, we remember those men and women who come to honor, you know, that will continue to live in our nation's memory, and something we, as we know, we must always continue to do. And what I would like to share with you today is a memory of some of the Pepsi Nintendo generation, as they called it. Right after 9/11 happened, when this country was ramping up for the current wars that they're in, you started hearing some of these talking heads and newscasts talking about that the Nintendo generation, the Pepsi generation, withstand the rigors of combat. And when I was with the 101st, we were ramping up the battalion. You know, these young Americans like to stand up and fight our country's wars. Well, I'm here to tell you that throughout our tour, when we launched out of Kuwait, we fought battles through Najaf, Karbala, Kalash, street to street, block to block. And these young Nintendo generation, this Pepsi generation of men and women never faltered. You know, when we fought through many of these areas, you know, it's a natural tendency to want to stay down and duck and hide, but they never did that. Through many of the sounds of the guns, they continued to march forward and they fought. But something that many of our veterans had told us before that we left out of Fort Campbell, Kentucky for the invasion was something that we'll always remember. Something that is not new, it's something that has special meaning right before you leave to see combat, many of us for a first time. And they said, you know, when you fight, trust your training. But also when you fight, you will fight for each other. And that's what many of those young veterans did as they were fought through many of the places as we were fighting up through southern Iraq and eventually to get to Mosul. But something I'll tell you is that, you know, it wasn't easy. Anytime that you spend a year in combat, there's potentially with the kind of fighting that we were doing, there was going to be casualties. Unfortunately, the battalion during that combat tour, we lost 9 of our own throughout the battalion. We lost 62 throughout the division. But when we returned home, one of the things that the 101st does is a thing called a Week of the Eagles. During the Week of the Eagles, they bring in the families of the fallen. They bring in veterans throughout that entire week. Throughout that week, we had memorials to those 9 that we had followed throughout the battalion. We invited the families to join us. You know, there was many hugs and tears as we remembered the fallen that we had. The one thing was evidently clear as you met the families. You could see right away where those 9 that we had lost, where they got the intestinal fortitude and where they got the right to raise their right hand to defend country and against foreign enemies, both foreign and domestic, and why did they join the service and did what they did. You know, and that's something that I'll tell you is that, you know, as I think about all that we have and that we cherish throughout this country, you know, we wake up every day underneath that blanket of freedom. And we wake up that blanket of freedom because of many of the sacrifices that the veterans and those who have fallen have done. But as we know, freedom isn't free. And as we continue, there's also so many things that, you know, we have to be thankful for. You know, this country did not become a great country by accident. We earned it. And while we may keep up and continue to put that blanket of freedom around our country, Our blood and sacrifice is an undisputable part of the world equation. We keep a large portion of the world free no matter what disaster strike, tsunamis, earthquakes. How many times have you seen the first ones on the ground was a soldier, a Marine, or could have been Air Force flying in supplies, navies off the coast, church groups gathering and rallying the people to gather things together to send for less the unfortunate. So I would surmise to you that that sacrifice is not just that blanket of freedom that we wake up to every morning, but it's a large part of what keeps the world free. I will leave you with this, and that is that, you know, being a part of something and an honor to have served in this uniform, I have never once since 9/11 that I've served has the American public swayed to support. That simple handshake in the airport, that pat on the back to that young soldier, sailor, airman, marine, or coast guard still means as much today as it ever did. And we want to thank you for that. For everything that you have done for your United Forces who serve each and every day, keep up that wall of freedom around this great country. I want to thank you personally. I'm honored to have had an opportunity to spend a few minutes with you sharing some memories that I've had during my time in uniform. And God bless you. And God bless you.
His uniform for all he loses back home. Elmer P. Richter, Washington soldier, writes of a battlefield of which America should be proud, his experience abroad. He realized the enormous opportunity lay in living back home, such as studying and learning a suitable trade and the money I might be pocketing. Put all these things together 1,000 times, I wouldn't take my uniform off at present if they were to be mine. So writes Elmer P. Richter, a Washington boy of Battery A, 110th Field Artillery, 29th Division, American Expeditionary Forces, to his father, Charles Richter, from one of the camps in France. I have now spent over here 2 months, he writes. My first month was on detached service, and I was fortunate enough to see a great deal I have often read of or seen only in pictures before in the papers. I have traveled all over the country and visited many of the important cities of the world. I have walked past posts before the large gates of the French fort outside of Paris. I have visited what was the front where the Americans first stepped in. I was in the town of Chateau Thierry. That was the place the American doughboys and the Marines flew, they were made of, and set the example to which every American in France would do his best to follow. I roamed all through the village and several miles around, and it in the large wheat fields infested with shell holes and articles that the Germans left behind in their hasty retreat. I was on the battlefield which America should be proud of, and which France has so vainly tried to recover. I was at the Red Cross of France, the farthest on the line, as far as any in the world, with every convenience and comfort for our wounded. While the wounded boys were being loaded in, and believe me, they were a happy bunch in spite of their pain and anger. I talked with many fresh from the line, and the spirit they showed was beyond my power. Not one of them could I hear complain of pain or fatigue or of hunger, for it is often impossible to get food when they are advancing. And that is the only thing our boys know, advance. They are a fine lot of men, and often boys, and all you people back home appreciate them. You will take off your hats to those who come home, not forgetting those who remain. Another thing we should all thank is the Red Cross and the YMCA. There is nothing like them. Everywhere one goes, we find them helping them, and they often bring memories of home. So if you ever feel charitable, give what you can to them. We are now in a large American artillery camp, and are learning the French guns and a great deal of that there. After our training here, which won't be long, we are due for the line. And when we go, we are going to try to keep the reputation for which America has made for herself and to do our bit to help make a quick end to the war. For freedom, we gather here today to pay respect and honor on this Memorial Day for those who died for others that all men might be free, the pride of our great nation, the sons of liberty. For all the sons and daughters who heard their nation's call, for all the missing heroes on the Vietnam War, for all the weeping fathers who gave this land their own, for mothers who rocked the cradle of great heroes that we've known, for those with pale blue ribbons, for our sailors who rest at sea, remember this Memorial Day. Freedom is not free. Reflection on honor, sacrifice, and duty. Americans across this nation and citizens around the world will pause throughout this day to observe Memorial Day. Since its first official observation on May 5th, 1868, when it was called Declaration Day, it has been a day of remembrance for those who sacrificed and died in our nation's service. And while it was originally dedicated to Civil War soldiers, we know it today as a celebration and memory of all who have fought for and defended our right to freedom. In 1968, the observation of this day was established to be the last Monday time. Today, it remains a time of observation to honor and to respect those who fought to protect the liberties that our country was founded upon. In his proclamation to set aside this day in 1868, General Logan instructed there be thoughts to cherish tenderly the memories of our heroic deeds, who made their breath a barricade between our country and its foes. To those who died, to all those who fought, we owe the honor of our respect for delivering to us freedom upon nothing less than the commitment of their life and the willingness to lose it for that defense. Harry Truman once said, "I think I know the American soldier. He does not want gratitude or sympathy. He had a job to do. He did not like it. But he did it, and how he did it. Now he wants to come back home and start again the life he loved." So let us pause with respect and honor on this Memorial Day to remember those who fought, for those who gave their lives, and for those who willingly stand ready to do so today without question when freedom of defense calls them. We owe each of them the highest regard, respect, and honor, and the assurance that their commitment to this nation's freedom will never be forgotten. Our armed forces continue to maintain the same standard of commitment and honor that was declared more than two centuries ago. Our flag is truly a symbol of the freedoms that we fought so diligently to protect, from Key's vision of bombs bursting through the morning air to the courageous memory of Marines raising the flag at Iwo Jima. The American flag is a symbol of freedom that we celebrate and hold sacred. Let it also remind each of us of the sacrifice made by men and women throughout our nation so that this flag could stand tall.
And let us not forget that we will never see it waived as a nation of free people because of the lives that we honor each Memorial Day. On this Memorial Day, pause to reflect on just what has been given and sacrificed so freely, so that freedom can ring across this great land.
Throughout the country. Donations received in return for these artificial poppies have helped countless veterans and their widows, widowers, and orphans over the years. The poppy itself continues to serve as a perpetual tribute to those who have given their lives for this nation's freedom. In Flanders Fields. In Flanders Fields, the poppies blow. Between the crosses, grow and fall. That mark our place. And in the sky, the larks the bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the dumb field. We are the dead, the days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow. Love and were loved, and now we lie at Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, take you from falling hands with foe. The torch be yours to hold it high. If you break faith with us, we shall not sleep, for the poppies grow.
Anyone remember? Anyone remember? Anyone remember? About the land, the
the concept of Gold Star Families started with the Baltimore Blind Service Club, which contained blue stars for each family member serving when the United States was engaged in war or hostilities. If that soldier died, the blue star was replaced with a gold one. Jerry Walters spoke just now at Christopher Swanson. When he died on his third tour in Iraq, his family sadly became a Gold Star family. In the words of Christopher's father, words we should always keep in mind, he said, "But for those who have lost a loved one, a friend, a battle buddy, every day is Memorial Day." The motto of the Swanson Foundation, founded to help Gold Star families, is, "A soldier only dies if they are forgotten." As we leave here today, we must follow the example of our beloved Dick Johnson. We must promise to remember and acknowledge all the countless men and women who have answered our nation's call and have sacrificed all they have. Before we leave, we need to do one more thing that we forgot to do when the Armed Forces Medley was played. We forgot to ask our veterans and our active military to stand so that we can acknowledge them, so we can thank them, and so we can show them our support. Please stand, all those who have served in the Armed Forces.
first hour of Hearts and Prayer. Father, we are here today because we refuse to forget. Lord, we refuse to forget the lives of the men and women who sacrificed so willingly to serve this great nation so that we could be this great bastion of hope and freedom throughout the world. Lord, we refuse to forget not just their lives, but the sacrifices that many made. And Lord, today we remember the cost of that great freedom. We remember that many shed their blood, many gave their lives, so that we could stand here today and actually do all that we do today, so that we can drive freely to stores, so that we can go and worship, so that we can govern ourselves, so that we can enjoy so many liberties. But Lord, we refuse to forget the cost. And so, Lord, today I pray that as we remember, Lord, those families that are hurting, Lord, we hurt with them. And we ask that you would just meet them and that you would just envelop them with your Holy Spirit and that you would comfort and be with them. And Lord, today we recognize that in and of ourselves we cannot, as Abraham Lincoln said, we cannot dedicate or consecrate or hallow this ground. But what we can do is dedicate ourselves to never forgetting their memory and to continue to fight and to continue to live in and for the freedoms that they so willingly gave their lives for. And so, Lord, today we find also ourselves surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. Lord, many who have fought and are here today. And Lord, they've seen many battle scars and they've seen the loss of many of their friends and their comrades. Lord, we're grateful for them as well. And Lord, we pray that you would bless them as they have blessed us in this nation. We pray that you would meet them and that you would just be with them as well. And Lord, today we're reminded of their greatness, that they truly are the heroes. And we're reminded of what your word tells us, that to be the greatest of all, we have to be a servant. And Lord, all of these have done just that. So we pray your blessing upon them. We pray your blessing upon their families. And that you would meet them and be with them. That you would comfort them. That you would meet their every need. That you would just allow your favor to shine down upon them. And so Lord, today as we take the time to remember, we will celebrate the memories. We will celebrate this nation and all that they have fought for and as many have died for. And we will celebrate their lives. And we will celebrate the opportunity to have known them and to have been in some way affected by their lives. And we thank you for them. And so, Lord, we pray that you would consecrate, that you would dedicate, that you would memorialize this day, and that you would shine your favor upon each and every one. And Lord, that this nation would not lose your favor as we fight for freedom, the very thing that's so dear to your heart. And we will be quick to give you the glory, the honor, in Jesus' name. Amen.